Choral Evensong is broadcast today from Carlisle Cathedral. The Canticles are set to Walford Davies in G, and the anthem is The Plum and Wasp is Boiling in the Kitchens by Derek Bourgeois.
To the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, and ever shall be, O Lord, in us all. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord. Psalm is that appointed for the 24th evening.
Thank you.
first lesson is written in the second book of Kings, the third chapter, beginning at the fourth verse. Now Misha, king of Moab, was a sheep breeder, and he had to deliver annually to the king of Israel 100,000 lambs and the wool of 100,000 rams. But when Ahab died, the king of Moab rebelled against the king of Israel. So King Jehoram marched out of Samaria at that time and mustered all Israel. And he went and sent word to Jehoshaphat, king of Judah, "The king of Moab has rebelled against me. Will you go out with me to battle against Moab?" And he said, "I will go. I am as you are, my people as your people, my horses as your horses." Then he said, "By which way shall we march?" Jehoram answered, "By the way of the wilderness of Edom." So the king of Israel went with the king of Judah and the king of Edom. And when they had made a circuitous march of 7 days, there was no water for the army or for the beasts which followed them. Then the king of Israel said, "Alas, the Lord has called these three kings to give them into the hand of Moab." And Jehoshaphat said, "Is there no prophet of the Lord here through whom we may inquire of the Lord?" Then one of the king of Israel's servants answered, "Elisha the son of Shaphat is here, who poured water on the hands of Elijah." And Jehoshaphat said, "The word of the Lord is with him." So the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat and the king of Edom went down to him. And Elisha said to the king of Israel, "What have I to do with you? Go to the prophets of your father and the prophets of your mother." But the king of Israel said to him, "No, it is the Lord who has called these three kings to give them into the hand of Moab." And Elisha said, "As the Lord of hosts lives, whom I serve, were it not that I have regard for Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, I would neither look at you nor see you. But now bring me a minstrel." And when the minstrel played, the power of the Lord came upon him. And he said, "Thus says the Lord, I will make this dry stream bed full of pools. For thus says the Lord, you shall not see wind or rain, but that stream bed shall be filled with water, so that you shall drink, you, your cattle, and your beasts. This is a light thing in the sight of the Lord. He will also give the Moabites into your hand. And you shall conquer every fortified city and every choice city, and shall fell every good tree, and stop up all springs of water, and ruin every good piece of land with stones." The next morning, about the time of the offering of the sacrifice, behold, water came from the direction of Edom till the country was filled with water. When all the Moabites heard that the kings had come up to fight against them, all who were able to put on armor, from the youngest to the oldest, were called out and were drawn up at the frontier. And when they rose early in the morning, and the sun shone upon the water, the Moabites saw the water opposite them as red as blood. And they said, "This is blood. The kings have surely fought together and slain one another. Now then, Moab, to the spoil. But when they came to the camp of Israel, the Israelites rose and attacked the Moabites till they fled before them. And they went forward, slaughtering the Moabites as they went. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you.
The second lesson is written in the Acts of the Apostles, the 17th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Now when Paul and Silas had passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia, they came to Thessalonica, where there was a synagogue of the Jews. And Paul went in, as was his custom, and for 3 weeks he argued with them from the Scriptures, explaining and proving that it was necessary for the Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead, and saying, "This Jesus, whom I proclaim to you, is the Christ." And some of them were persuaded and joined Paul and Silas, as did a great many of the devout Greeks, and not a few of the leading women. But the Jews were jealous, and taking some wicked fellows of the rabble, they gathered a crowd, set the city in an uproar, and attacked the house of Jason, seeking to bring them out to the people. And when they could not find them, they dragged Jason and some of the brethren before the city authorities, crying, "These men who have turned the world upside down have come here also, and Jason has received them, and they are all acting against the decrees of Caesar, saying there is another king, Jesus." And the people and the city authorities were disturbed when they heard this, and when they had taken security from Jason and the rest, they let them go. The brethren immediately sent Paul and Silas away by night to Berea. And when they arrived, they went into the Jewish synagogue. Now these Jews were more noble than those in Thessalonica, for they received the word with all eagerness, examining the Scriptures daily to see if these things were so. Many of them therefore believed, with not a few Greek women of high standing, as well as men. But when the Jews of Thessalonica learned that the word of God was proclaimed by Paul at Berea also, they came there too, stirring up and inciting the crowds. Then the brethren immediately sent Paul off on his way to the sea, but Silas and Timothy remained there. Those who conducted Paul brought him as far as Athens, and receiving a command for Silas and Timothy to come to him as soon as possible, they departed. Here ends the second lesson.
Servant, depart.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and stood on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Ministers with righteousness.
And give us your
peace. O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord. Clean our hearts within us. O Lord, we beseech thee, let thy continual pity cleanse and defend thy church, and because it cannot continue in safety without thy succor, preserve it evermore by thy help and goodness, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The words of the anthem are, the plum and wasp is boiling in the kitchens, great nets spawn silver into trawlers' hulls. These words are taken from a poem by Ian Freegard. The music is by Derek Bourgeois.
Let us pray. harvest and giver of our daily bread, we rejoice in all thy loving goodness, and pray that thy kindness may so prevail in the hearts of thy children everywhere. The earth may be filled with gladness and peace through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
So we pray for all who farm, especially in this county. Give, O Lord, to all who till the ground wisdom to understand thy laws and to cooperate with thy wise ordering of the world. And grant that the bountiful fruits of the earth may not be hoarded by the selfish or squandered by the foolish, but that all who work may share abundantly in the harvest of the soil, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We pray for all in need, through sickness or unemployment or want. O Lord, we beseech thee, who art the succour of the succourless, the hope of them past hope, the saviour of the tempest-tossed, the harbour of the voyagers, the physician of the sick. Thyself become all things to all men, who knowest each one in his petition, each house in its need. And receive us all into thy kingdom, making us children of light, and thy peace and love bestow upon us, O Lord our God.
Amen.
In 100 hymns we sing number 37, God Whose Farm Is All Creation, the words by John Arlott.